Hey guys, I'm Alex. So I was asked how did I make that death cam in my grenade tutorial, which I linked in the description and in the eye of the video, where when I use a grenade, my character goes into ragdoll and flies away, but the camera follows the character as it goes away instead of actually being attached to the character. Well, this is pretty easy and I will show you how to do it. So first of all, on our character, we have two ways to do this, either through a timer or through the event tick. Let's set up the timer first. We'll need a custom event and we'll do something like do death cam, and we'll call a timer here, set timer by function name, and we'll call this death cam. So that was do death cam, this is death cam, which we'll call a different event, and we can call this every 0.01 seconds and make sure it's looping. Now we can make another custom event, which is the custom event in this timer, which will be called by the timer every 0.01 seconds, death cam. Now we'll get our follow camera, so the camera that comes with the character, we'll get it. We'll get the world location. Then we'll also need our mesh's location, our mesh being our character. So this one, we'll drag it in as well, and we'll do the same, also get world location. We'll drag from the first one, from the camera location, and we'll find look at rotation, and we'll connect the get world location in here as well. And then from the death cam custom event, we'll set world rotation of our follow camera. So basically it's this one, which we can just connect directly and can delete this. And from here, we'll connect the find look at rotation. Now that's done on the character itself. The next part is on our grenade, which we made in the previous two-part tutorial. So when we spawn our grenade and it detects our character, we minus the health, and if the health reaches zero, which we're checking here, if true, we'll disable input of the character, we'll make sure to set the collision to physics of the mesh of our character, and also will enable set simulate physics. Then I will add an impulse to send the mesh away flying because of the explosion. And now here, to make our camera follow, we'll need to grab from our character, where we are doing here the cast with the character, to our character. I already have the line going, the blue line. So I have here a pin from which I'll drag, and I'll call the do death cam custom event, which will trigger our timer. Now, okay, let's see if that works. So I spawned a grenade, I get damaged, and there we go. It's working, just nice. And now the second way you can do this, it's with the event tick if you want it to be smoother, though of course with the set timer, you can also make it even smoother if you just like add, for example, another zero and make it 0.001. And this is like super smooth, but this might actually be even more expensive than the tick based on how much FPS you have. So this will also work just fine. Nice and smooth. And then the other way we can do it with the event tick, it's by making a boolean, so something like do death cam question mark, and we'll put it at the event tick, we'll get it, we'll branch, and we'll connect this here and then this one to true here. Make sure your do death cam, it's false by default, so it's not turned on. And then we'll go back to our grenade, and again we'll drag from our character, which again this blue line is coming from a cast to my character, and we'll set do death cam boolean. Now I'll disconnect this one because this is the other way to do it, and I'll just check this. So we'll be turning the boolean to true, which will enable this branch to turn on and will allow the event tick to run to our set world rotation for our camera. And now if we try it, let me climb up here, ding ding ding, and grenade at our feet, we're flying. Hey, epic, nice. So I hope that works well for you. Another tutorial you should check out is my scanning environment tutorial, which is, as you see, you can scan and highlight items. And that is it. That's how you make the death cam. Hope that was useful. Use whichever method works better for you. I would say that setting timer by function name is the better way, but it's up to you. I'm just showing the options. All right. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe, and I will see you again in the next one. Woohoo!